Hello everyone! So for the first DIY we're going to make a very simple lace trim headband. All you'll need are scissors, lace trim, I got mine from Hancock Fabric in case you're wondering, an elastic piece, and thread and needle. I measure my lace trim to be around 15 centimeters or 5.5 inches, but everyone's heads are different sizes, so be sure to measure it. And the length of my elastic is the same as my lace trim. Then take your needle and thread and sew both sides together. And voila, you got yourself a super simple lace headband. Now moving on to your next DIY, which is a lace and set sweater. All you'll need is a sweater that you don't like or want, lace, scissors, and thread needle. Now lay your sweater on a flat surface and cut the sweater. I wanted mine to have this really cool W shape, so I cut it a trapezium, if I pronounce it right, shape. And yes, I did have to Google that word. And keep in mind, you can cut it any shape you want. And after you're done, don't throw the extra piece just yet. Fold your lace in half and place your extra piece sweater and cut a general shape of the extra piece with the lace. And keep in mind to leave about a centimeter or two of lace for hemming purposes. Finally, just attach the lace to the sweater. And since I hand sew everything, I sew the lace inside out. And voila, you're done. Now the next one is pretty simple and self-explanatory, but we're going to make a pocket tee. Now first, just measure out how big you want your pocket to be. Make sure to leave at least a centimeter for hemming purposes. Just trim the lace if you're not happy with the size, but if you're happy with the size, just hem the lace. And this is how I do it. I just fold the side and I just take some thread and needle and I just sew all four sides together. Here comes the fun part, and you just glue the three sides, and fabric glue should work at this point. And wait 24 hours for the glue to completely dry and you're basically done. Now moving on, this is a keychain bow. First, you will need a piece of lace and fabric. Just combine the two pieces together by sewing it. And if you know how to use a sewing machine, then go for it. And after you're done, flip your piece ugly side up and fold it back and forth an odd number of times. And if you like your bow to be small, then fold it vertically, but if you like it to be bigger, then fold it horizontally. Now just set your bow aside and get a small piece of lace and fold it into a thin strip. Now wrap that piece around the center of the bow and quickly sew the piece together while it is still wrapping the bow. Use scissors and chop the extra piece of lace. And to turn it into a keychain, you obviously need an empty keychain. And to connect the bow and the chain together, take a piece of wire and bend it into like a circle. Hook the wire to the chain and the lace of the bow together, then just close the wire. You're technically done, but if you want more security, then take a little bit of super glue or hot glue gun and just apply the glue to the wire and the lace to securely stick them together. And let the glue dry and your very cute lace bow is complete. Remember, you can definitely use other combinations however you want. And lastly, my favorite, the Peter Pan collar necklace. It looks hard and expensive to make, but trust me, it is super easy and super affordable to make. First, take a piece of paper and fold it in half. Then draw a moon-looking shape about the two tails. And it should look something like this, then just cut the shape out. And you would get like these two rabbit ears and just test it out, just put it on your chest to see if you like the size of the collar. And if you don't like it, then just trim it. Fold your felt in half and place your template and trace around it. Then cut the felt. And I didn't show this on camera, but I also made a duplicate of this. And after you cut out the felt, it should look exactly the same as the template. Then cut out a general shape of the collar with lace. Then connect the two pieces of felt and lace by sewing. And let me warn you, the back will not be pretty, but it's okay because we will cover it. And to attach the collar with the chain, I puncture a hole on the duplicate and the actual collar with a piece of nail. And careful with this because you can easily ruin your fingers while you're doing this. And then I just stuck a little piece of wire through the hole of the duplicate and actual collar. Then I used one of the rings from the chain that I'm going to use and opened it and hooked it to the wire. And I also placed the chain to the ring and closed it. And there you are basically done with one side of the collar. And to finish the collar, just attach the other side.
Remember the duplicate I was talking about? So basically the duplicate is to make sure that the collar will be a lot sturdier. So to attach the collar to the duplicate, all I did was just apply some fabric glue to the back of the duplicate and I just stuck them together.
And basically you're done! How easy is this? And also make sure your chain has a lobster clasp or else it will be extremely difficult to wear and take it off. And that's it for these 5 quick and simple DIY tutorials. I hope you guys enjoy this as much as I filmed this. And let me know which one is your favorite by leaving a comment down below. And thank you so much for watching and until next time, bye guys!